It is Kelman McPherson forceps. These are fine forceps with bent limb used to hold the superior septum of IOL during its placement. Second uses to tear off the anterior capsular pap in ECCE. Can be used for suture time. It is self-retaining lacrimal bone molar retractor. Its usage. It is used to retract the skin during surgery of the lacrimal sac. Example DCP or DCR. It is corneal tracheal. It is ptosis clamp. It has J-shaped and having internal serrations. The clamp has a locking mechanism. It uses to hold levator palpi superioris muscles during ptosis surgery. It is lens expressor. Hook. Its tip is knobbed. It is a flat metal handle with a rounded curve at one end. Tip of the curve is knobbed. The plane of the handle is at right angle to the curvature of the hook. Uses to apply pressure on the limbus at the 6 o'clock position during the delivery of lens in intracapsular cataract abstraction with Smith and capsule forceps technique. Second, used to express the nucleus in extracapsular cataract abstraction. Third use, it can also be used as muscle hook if the latter is not available. Fifth use, also used along with the wire vectis to extract out the dislocated lens. It is muscle hook, also known as strabismus hook. It is similar to the lens expressor in appearance but has a blunt guiding knob at the end to prevent muscle slippage. The plane of handle is the same as that of the curvature of the hook. It is used to engage the extraocular muscles during surgery for squint enucleation and retinal detachment. Second use, in the absence of lens expressor, it may be used in its place. It is chalazion clamp. It consists of two limbs like forceps which can be clamped with the help of a screw. These are. The tip of one limb is flattened in the form of round disc while the tip of other arm has a small circular ring. This is a small circular ring and this is flat end. The flat disc is applied on the skin side and the ring on the conjunctival side of the chalazion uses to fix the chalazion and achieve hemostasis during incision and curettage. It is lid clamp or entropion clamp. Advantage over lid spatula. It is self-retaining instrument and does not need an assistant to hold. Disadvantage. Operative field is less. Pressure necrosis can occur if fitted tightly. Usage. It is used in lid surgery, entropion and ectropion correction. It protects the eyeball, supports the lid tissue and provides hemostasis during surgery. It is evisceration curettage. It consists of oval or rounded shallow cup with blunt margin. Attached a stout handle. Uses to curate out the intraocular contents during evisceration operation. Optic nerve guide. Enucleation spoon. It is a spoon-shaped instrument with a central cleavage. Uses to engage the optic nerve during enucleation. It is lacrimal sac dissector and curette. It is a cylindrical instrument. One end of is blunt and other end is tipped dissector and other end is curative. Uses in lacrimal sac surgery. It is bone punch. Uses It is used to enlarge the bony opening during DCR operation by punching the bone from margin of the opening. It is lacrimal probe, Bowman's probe. These are a set of straight metal bars of varying thickness, size 0 to 8, with blunt, rounded ends and flattened central platform, used to probe nasolacrimal duct in congenital blockage. Second, used to identify the lacrimal sac during DCP and DCR operation. It is Bayer speculum. Its uses. Eye speculum are used to keep the lid apart during any intraocular operation such as cataract surgery and glaucoma surgery, any extraocular surgery, example stent surgery and pterygium surgery, enucleation and evisceration operation, removal of conjunctival and corneal foreign body, cauterization of corneal ulcer, examination of the eye in a patient with glaucoma. It is corneal seizure or section enlarging seizure. Usage. These are used to enlarge corneal or corneosclerosal incision for conventional intracapsular and extracapsular cataract extraction. Cataract surgery. To enlarge corneal incision and keratoplasty operation and to cut the scleral and trabecular tissue in trabeculectomy. It is Debaker seizures. They are fine seizures with small blade directed at right angle to the arm. These blades are apart, making B safe. By spring action usage. It is used to perform iridectomy, and to cut out the prolapse from vitreous and papillary membrane. It is needle holding forceps. It is eyeball holding forceps. It is a spring action forceps with short, blunt and curved blades having smooth edge and tip with platform teeth. Its uses. To hold optic of non-foldable PMMA lens eyeball during implantation. It is superior rectus holding forceps. S-shaped double curve near the tip tooth forceps. Its uses. First, hold the superior rectus muscles while passing a bridle finger under it to stabilize the eyeball during any operation such as cataract surgery, glaucoma surgery and corneal surgery. It is synchoid cannula. Irrigation and aspiration of lens matter in ECCE. It is iris depositor handle with blade and blunt edges. Uses to reposit iris in anterior chamber after intraocular surgery. Second, use to break senescence at pupillary margin. It is capsulorectus forceps. After a flap lens capsule is raised, used for holding lens capsule. It is corneosclerosal forceps. Its uses. These are used to hold the cornea or scleral edge for suturing during cataract, glaucoma, repair of corneal and scleral tears and keratoplasty operation. It is castrovisio caliper. It is used to take measurement during squint, ptosis, retinal detachment and part plana vitrectomy surgery. It is also used to measure corneal diameter and visible horizontal iris diameter. It is Bayer vectis. It is Bayer loop attached to a metallic handle. Its uses. It is used to remove dislocated or subluxated lens and nucleus in ECCE. It is chopper, resembling scissors' hook in shape. The inner edge of the bent tip is cutting and may have different angle. Its uses. It is used to split or chop the nucleus into smaller pieces and also for nuclear manipulation and hypoimmobilization. patient surgery. It is IOL dialer. It has fine bent tip attached with a stout handle. Its usage. It is used to dial the PMMA non-foldable IOL for proper positioning in the capsular bag or ciliary sulcus. Second use. It can also be used to manipulate the nucleus in phacoemulsification surgery. It is cascant knife. Blunt tipped bevel of knife having cut splitting action at the tip end and both sides. Its usage. It is used to make tunnel incision in the sclera and cornea for phacoemulsification, manual small incision cataract surgery and sutureless trabeculectomy. It is keratin diamond shaped blade with a sharp apex and two cutting edges. Its uses. Valvular corneal incision for entry into the anterior chamber for all modern technique of cataract extraction and self-sealing incision for SICS and phacoemulsification. It is sideboard entry blade stating knife with a sharp pointed tip and cutting on one side. Its uses. It is used to make a small valvular clear corneal incision, commonly called as sideboard incision in phacoemulsification and other intraocular surgery, including pars plana and vitrectomy.